Hello students, now in today's video we will try to solve few questions of stock and share again so that you have even clearer understanding of the topic. Now let's look at this question. A man invested rupees 1500 in a stock at 95 to obtain an income of 130. What is the dividend from the stock? Now understand this thing. They may confuse you with the different kind of data, but you have to keep in mind that what you need to solve this question. Now I want at what percent he will earn, what percent of income he will earn. Simple. Now if you are asking me what is his dividend from stock, percentage of income he is getting, right? So I can simply solve this question by keeping in mind that I am earning 130 rupees against 1500, right? So this will be equivalent to, I will just try to solve this, this will be equivalent to 8.33, right? Now there can be other possibility as well. The other possibility is that to obtain an income of rupees 130, so other possibility is how many shares he have purchased. So if I want to calculate it on rupees 95 rupees, in that case it will be different, right? Because 8.33 is on 100 rupees, right? It is on 100 rupees. If I want to calculate it on 95, it will be more. But I hope you understand the concept here. It will be 8.33%. He is just earning 8.33% against his investment. Now Naresh invested rupees 5940 in rupees 20 share quoted at rupees 18. If the rate of dividend is 15, find his annual income. Now if you look at this question, they are asking you about the annual income. Now annual income he will earn, it is given that he is earning 15 rupees, 15%. Now 15% on what? 15% he is getting on 20 rupees, not 18, right? He is getting on 20 rupees. So what is 15% of 20? 3 rupees. So he is getting 3 rupees in against every share he has bought. So per share he is getting 3 rupees. How many share he has purchased? He invested 5940 and per share amount was 18. He invested 5940 and per share amount was, or per share he has paid 18 rupees. So number of share are here, dividend he will earn per share will be 3. So just solve this, right? So 5940 divided by 18, this will give me 9, 9 and 0. So my answer will be 990 rupees, right? I hope it is clear. Find the income on 8.5% stock of rupees 4000 purchased at rupees 90. Now again, how many shares he would have purchased? He would have purchased 4000 divided by 90, right? So this is the number of share he would have purchased, multiply by how much amount he is getting per share? 8.5. So you just have to solve this and you will get your answer. The same concept that we discussed in the last question, the same is applied in this question as well. Okay, next question. Suresh buys 100 shares of face value rupees 7 each of a company which pays an annual dividend of rupees 12 at such a price that he gets 10% on in investment. What is the market value of the share? Now as per company's claim, he is getting 12% dividend, right? He is getting 12% dividend, but actually he is getting only 10%, right? So face value of the share is 7 rupees. If he is getting less amount of money, if he is getting less amount of money, that means the share value will be more. The share value will be more. That is why percentage has decreased, right? So definitely I will use again these two values in order to increase the value of this. How I will increase the value? I will multiply it by 12 and divide it by 10, right? So when I will solve this, I will get 8.4. That is my answer. I hope you understood the question. The question is simple, that as per company he is getting 12%, right? But actually he is getting 10%. So I can also say that 12% of 7 is equivalent to 10% of X, right? X is the price he is actually paying. So I will just solve this. How I will solve this? Again, everything will be cancelled. So this will be equivalent to 12 into 7 is equivalent to 10 into X, or I can say that X is equivalent to 7 into 12 upon 10, 84 by 10 will give me 8.4. So if you can apply this thing directly, this will save a lot of time, right? But otherwise, if you want to use the concept only and you're not getting this, you can go with the concept as also. It will not take that much of time. Raman invested rupees 347200 in 5% stock at 120. If the brokerage is 4, find the annual income from his investment. Now he has invested 347200, right? Now number of shares, understand this is a 5% stock. So in order to find out his income, what I need to do is, first of all, number of share I have to find out. Now number of share, for in order to find out number of share, first of all, total investment is this, per share amount is 120. But remember that he also paid brokerage of 4 rupees. Now it is directly given 4 rupees. If it was 4%, I would have said 4% of 100 rupees. But they have directly given you 4 rupees. So he has paid, per share he has paid 4 rupees. So 120 plus 4 will give me 124. This is the number of share he has purchased. Multiply by, he is getting 5% per share. So 5 rupees, right? Because understand, it will be a 100 rupees share, he is getting 5 rupees against each share. So when I will solve this, right, what I will get? If I solve this, I will get 2800 into 5 will give me 14,000. So my answer will be 14,000, not this one, but this one. I have to be very careful in this kind of situation as well. We have to be careful because sometimes the figures are so similar that we tend to make the mistake, right? So, our answer is C only. I hope it is clear. So, that was all as far as stocks and shares were concerned. You have to practice more questions to make sure that you are not missing out on any question that will come in an aptitude test. So, that is all from my side. Have a good day. Thank you.